And on behalf of the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, and the collaboration that we have with the Government of Canada, I want to flag off these wonderful women, the women who can speak English.
Yes.
That's very important because they are not only in Uganda, they are in English, they can speak multiple languages. So we flag you off to go and talk for us.
Women entrepreneurs have made great strides and boosted the economy over the years. This is why government is putting in place mechanisms to provide them opportunities in the global markets. With the support of the Government of Canada, over 200 women have been equipped with export readiness skills, including e-marketing and governance. The State Minister of Trade, Harriet Ntabazi, explained that out of these women, 10 were selected and have been flagged off to Canada today.
The selection of these women is class, and it is on conditions set by the market. That is one of the issues. And why only 10? Yes, they are the ones who qualified first.
The minister gave assurance that the selected women are already fully equipped and will not frustrate government's efforts by disappearing once they land in Canada.
There is no woman who is going to remain there. I want to assure your husbands, to assure your families, to assure Ugandans that these women we are sending there are going to come back.
To help the country fully recover from the negative impacts of COVID-19, the minister said government recently dispersed 200 billion shillings for the small-scale business entrepreneurs.
We are looking at Uganda's exports now moving high in terms, because majorly we are targeting agricultural products. Our products majorly included coffee, tea, cotton, and all those. We were not putting an eye majorly on crafts and those home decors, which the AGOA market and other markets are targeting. So we are moving forward, more especially now that we have a clear market.
Report by Juliet Namoya for the news.